Alright, so welcome back to episode 12. It just turned Blood Moon, and I'm insanely happy about that because we might be able to get the Shark Tooth necklace in the end. So let's go and buy a Zerg potion. But yeah, I went ahead and built, or like, I'm gonna show you in a second. Let me just go back to spawn real quick. I went ahead and built a Flying Mushroom Island over here, as you can see. This is for the Truffle NPC because I wanted to get the Auto Hammer, which I now have, so I can make Shroom Mypass. Let's go, the fun begins. And basically that's about it. Also, one thing I wanted to point out right now, in my last episode I sounded like I was pretty, I don't know, sad the entire time, the entire episode. And I had this one thing in the back of my mind that kept dragging me down the entire day and the entire recording session, so I sounded pretty demotivated and all. I'm sorry about that. I just wanted to record because I didn't want to leave you guys with yet another day without episodes. So I just went ahead and recorded even though it wasn't a good idea. But yeah, it turned out to not be the best episode I ever had, to be honest. I wasn't completely happy with it, but in the end, like, I didn't want to make you guys wait even longer. It's all good now, I'm in a pretty good mood today, just woke up and recorded again. Also, we got the Blood Zombie banner, that's all I need. So we can technically just skip it already. I mean, the Blood Moon itself isn't really useful to us anymore. All we need is the banner. Because with that we can finally, after ages, make the Shark Tooth necklace. God, this took way too long. So what else did we need for the Delphic Amulet? We needed... Oh yeah, this is gonna be a farm session. So Stardust, we have enough of that. Meteorite bars, we might have enough. Let's check. Yeah, we do. Jellyfish necklace, I think we got that one dropped not too long ago. Panic necklace, we might not have that. Because I didn't destroy enough Crimson Altars. Let me just take a look at like Delphic Amulet recipe. Yeah, we are missing Star Veil, which I have in my inventory. Celestial Cuffs, which we can make, and the Panic Necklace, okay. So let's make the Celestial Cuffs. Oh wait, we can't? Magic Cuffs, how do we make Magic Cuffs? Mana Regeneration Band, and I feel like... Yeah, I think we made that one. Or did we? I remember having that accessory for some reason. But I guess we didn't. Ah, great. So I also have to do that. And then we have... Oh yeah, all of those got resplited. And renamed accordingly. They look pretty cool now, because obviously the ore got resplited as well, with the Abyss update. I like the new splits, look amazing. Oh yeah, and what I didn't show in last episode, I went ahead and made those two swords. The first one is the Chaotic Sword, which I was recommended, and it looks pretty good. But I haven't had the chance to actually test it yet. And then I made the Lucretia. Which looks pretty amazing. It's a short sword that shoots out a beam, and basically if you hit an enemy with the blade, you have a 50% chance to be immune for a short amount of time. So you get immunity frames for like, I don't know, 3 frames, maybe, if I had to guess. So that's pretty useful actually, like you could technically tank a boss if you got lucky enough. And then again, I don't know if I said it already, I installed the helpful NPC mod again, which means we will get some more unique NPCs in order to make farming and all of that a bit less painful, because I'm just not the person to farm. I just don't enjoy it. Alright, so Delphic Amulet is delayed once again. It won't be anything. However, we should be able to make Shroom Mypass. Oh no, we're missing Chlorophyte. But the good thing is, since I installed helpful NPC, I don't need to waste my time going into the jungle now. So I can go ahead and just buy the Chlorophyte bars. They're pretty expensive, so I won't buy too much. Let's put them in here. Shroom Mite bars. We don't even need too much. Okay, but we definitely need more than this. Alright, and now I wanted to make the... Like, let's just take a look in general what we can make with Shroom Mite bars. Shroom Mite bars. This is what I wanted to make. The Shroomer is also a weapon I might be making because I like the Spectre Rifle so much. This is technically an upgrade to it. Dual Containment Unit, no thanks. Yeah, I guess the only thing I'm gonna be doing is the IRs because this is recommended to me. So we should still have the Spectre Bars. Yeah, we have enough. So I'll just need the Phoenix Blast at this point. I'm not sure if we have a handgun or not. I feel like we have. Alright, no we don't. So I gotta have to go into the dungeon again, get myself a handgun, and then I should be able to make it already. So let's go down and head into the dungeon. Okay, so guess what? My game crashed again. while opening magic storage. Okay, but we still have the Phoenix Blaster because I crafted that one already. Perfect. And this means we we can make this pistol. So I don't know if this is full auto or not. Because of Omni Swing still on. So this might be a bit too strong because we have Omni Swing on still. We will see. I'm interested to see how this weapon actually performs. I'm just gonna go ahead and enchant it and then disable Omni Swing because I feel like we won't need Omni Swing for later weapons anymore, and for this weapon it seems broken. Unreal, nice. Okay, so I'm gonna go disable the mod real quick. Alright, so moment of truth. Omni Swing is disabled. Oh yeah, so you have to click it. Thank God I disabled Omni Swing then. So I don't know if I'm gonna be using this weapon too much because this clicking is pretty annoying in the recording. So like, even though it might be a really good weapon, I mean, I might use it in a boss fight when I mute myself anyways. But I can see why this weapon is pretty good. Anyways, it's time to prepare for Plaguebringer Goliath. I still don't know, I think after Fish Run is the time when I'm gonna be trying Old World's Army Tier 3. I mean, I tried it in my last episode, I just didn't show it and I got completely demolished in Phase 3. Because I just feel like we are not meant to fight it already. I mean, yeah, right after Golem is a bad idea anyways, so I guess I'm gonna wait until Fish Run. But it's time to go into the jungle. Because we are going to go for the Plague Cells, if I recall correctly, that's the name. So that we can make the Goliath spawner. Now, Goliath is gonna be insanely hard. I always, like, the boss in Death Mode itself isn't really hard if you prepare enough, because you can get the two accessories that will make it pretty easy. But I'm not gonna be getting those. Oh yeah, now that Omni Swing is disabled, I just realized the Spectra rifle is semi-auto as well. So like, I press mouse 1, I hold it, nothing happens. So that might be why the weapon was so good. Oh no. It wasn't my intention, I didn't know it. Alright. But yeah, besides the fact that the clicking will be really annoying in the recording, this weapon is pretty good. The thing is, I can keep a pretty good speed with this, and consistently, so I feel like Omni Swing wouldn't be the biggest advantage. Because I really want to use weapons like this without having the recording. Like, you're gonna hear a lot of clicking. Alright, so I'm gonna be farming 10 of those. I'm not gonna be making any of the supportive accessories for the boss. Like I already said. Because in case you didn't... Wait, another needle? Because in case you didn't know, you can craft the Alchemist Flask, which will make you immune to the debuff. And you can craft the Honeydew, I believe, which will halve the enemy, or like half the damage from Goliath. And those two combined make the fight pretty easy, even in death mode. So I decided I'm just not gonna do it. Which will mean that this fight will be complete torture. Alright, perfect. We are good to go. Never mind, we are not. My game crashed. I fucking hate this so much. Okay, so just to show you, after the crash, I lost all of the progression I did in the jungle, which means I'm gonna cheat in the spawner because we had all of the materials. And I really don't feel like farming that stuff again because my game crashed. Oh, it's Abomination, right? Yeah. So we have one attempt. God, this is just so annoying. Oh yeah, I forgot this is gonna start now. Well, okay, guess I'm just gonna refarm the spawner then, because it's not gonna... It shouldn't take too long. Also, those enemies have way too much HP. Okay, so I'm just gonna head back and then farm the rest of the spawner. I'm actually gonna farm like 2 or 3 of them in order to make it a bit less annoying. Also, it didn't crash, nice. Alright, so I'm just gonna go and prepare that. See you in a second. Alright, I'm back. I farmed a couple of the spawners, 3 to be exact. Same position. Now, in case you didn't know, let me explain how the despawning works, because a lot of people get it wrong. It's not just that the boss randomly decides to respawn. It's when you leave the jungle for too long. There's like a timer in the background, and if you are out of the jungle for too long, then she despawns. Which is the problem with fighting her on the surface. However, if you fight her in like the underground, it's just way too hard in my opinion. So, I don't know, it doesn't really make sense. So like, the thing is, you all know how biomes work in Terraria. If you jump up just like to this height, as you can see, just let me show it. This is considered surface already, about this height. So if you fly up to that height and you stay out of the biome for too long, then she will despawn. And she will also enrage if you stay up here. So it seems the boss is designed to be fought underground, however it's just way too hard to fight underground at the moment. I mean, it's technically possible, but I just don't feel like it. Plus, you have to have a really giant arena. So yeah, I'm just gonna be going with this. Let's take the potions next attempt. Alright! I forgot how hard this fight is. So yeah, I'm pretty sure I'm gonna farm the honeydew and alchemist flask anyways. The problem is, this weapon seems really fucking shit against the fight at least. So like, I'm gonna have to search a different one. I mean, I might as well just go with this again. But oh man, this weapon without Omniswing is gonna be pretty disgusting. Oh, my game crashed again, nice. I love it. Alright, so I'm starting to get annoyed again because it crashed like 3 times in the single farm session. And it's starting to really piss me off. So I made 4 of those spawners. I went ahead and got both of those accessories. Please, okay. Now it's just about like making some sort of arrows. I mean, okay, never mind. I'm gonna use the Arctic arrows. Okay, Great Bow of Tumul. This is the next chance. And with those accessories, it should be pretty easy. At least from my experience, it always was. Oh yeah, the DPS is way better. There we go. This bow is crazy, this bow is really good. I like it. Alright, so we got the yo-yo, the Plaguebringer bow, which also is pretty good and underused. I might just go ahead and use this from now on. Plague cells and the toxic heart. Oh yeah, and like as a side topic, I'm pretty hyped because in today's episode from Chippy's playthrough, he will encounter Deathmore Calamitas. And if you saw my episodes, I already said that I'm pretty hyped for that, since it's one of the hardest bosses in, like, Calamity, in my opinion, if you take progression into account. I wouldn't say it's harder than Yauron, but it's definitely top 5 for me, so I'm hyped to see how he will perform against it. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna have to make, like, a guide on it, because the fight has a lot of detail and a lot of strategies behind it, and if you first fight it with no experience, it's not gonna end well. But yeah, I'm pretty hyped to see. Also, if you haven't noticed already, watching Python and Chippy, I really enjoy those playthroughs and I watch basically every episode. Plus, I'm always in the comment section giving them advice if I care. Alright, so 4 times should be, 5 times even should be more than enough. I don't plan to do it any further. So, let's just deposit it all except for the treasure bags. We get the mask, which looks pretty shit. Okay, I'm not gonna be using that. Other than that, nothing... Yeah, nothing really special, but we got 7 platinum, so that's nice. And now we can make Arctic arrows, a shit ton of those. Or can we? Oh yeah, I miss, thank god man. So we can make 250 per bar, which means 6000. This should be more than enough. I never checked it, but can we find like those mushroom worms? Or mushroom bait or whatever it's called? Can we find the truffle worms? Can we find those on like the surface here? I never knew that. I'm hoping this works. If you can get truffle worms on the surface biome, then it would be pretty easy to farm. One of those cave enemies spawned here already. It's just that we have so many enemies spawning here. Alright, so I went ahead and bought a truffle worm because you can actually buy them from one of the NPCs from Helpful NPC mod. Or like useful, I don't even know what the name is properly. So we won't have to farm if I fail it now. Which is pretty convenient. Now fish run in death mode is complete bullshit because of phase 3. The teleport phase itself is pretty good. Like pretty easy actually if you know how to do it. However, he summons tornadoes in the third phase, which turn this fight into complete garbage. There's really not much skill involved in the last phase. So yeah, I'm hoping that it won't be too bad. I mean, it's really hard to hit fish run for like a good amount of damage in the third phase if you get adrenaline because of his teleport. And I'm gonna be saving up adrenaline for the third phase, so yeah, hopefully I can use it properly, which I doubt. So like, see, the tornadoes are just so bullshit because you literally have no space to dodge anything. Still got one adrenaline boost in the third phase, even though it's complete bullshit, so that's nice. Alright, so, and we got the pink guy's costume again, truffle worm, flare run, and the wings. Yeah, nothing too special. Since we have rage, or we don't, okay, but I'm just gonna be taking a couple of hits and then I'm gonna retry him. Is there like any enemy down here that can hit me? Oh no, we have a zen potion, okay. So I'm just gonna be trying it again. I feel like rage and adrenaline combined should be able to skip the last phase. But I'm gonna continue because I want to get the tsunami, even though this is not fun at all, but whatever. Hey, we no-hitted the fight, are you kidding me? We actually no-hitted, definitely not fish run. Holy shit, okay. And we still didn't get the tsunami. Oh man. But nice, and while we're at it, because I feel hyped, I'm just gonna be taking this on. Because I still want to get the community. And no community, whatever. We got the swords. Yeah, I'm just gonna do fish run right after. Oh, I fucked up. At least we got rage, so if I don't get hit anymore, I should be able to skip the last phase. Okay, come on, tsunami, please. And we still didn't get it. I mean, we got the wings in the first treasure bag, but we are not getting the tsunami. Alright, you know what? I'm just gonna leave it, because it's starting to become boring. Alright, whatever. I guess for the Old One's army I'm just gonna be using this bow then. I mean, this might actually be better than the tsunami, now that I think about it, I'm not sure. Anyways, we got those two off the list, next one is Ravager, which I'm not gonna do in today's episode. I'm actually gonna end the episode here. So in the end it was a really good episode, I actually managed to no-hit Deathmod Fish Run. So yeah, I'm proud of this episode, and at least I didn't sound like I was demotivated the entire time because I'm actually in a good mood today. See you in the next one, and goodbye.